The 80s, a fascinating era to live in. A time for colorful clothes, mixtapes, and Michael Jackson. There are many prominent things about the 1980s, but not in this show. Because while The Shrink Next Door does take place in this era, the things that show that fact are a lot more subtle, in that everyone has perms and big beards. Will Ferrell and Paul Rudd are a powerful duo with incredible chemistry on camera, known most notably together for the Anchorman movies.
Blackbeard's delight. No, she gets a special cologne.
In which Will Ferrell plays the lead while Paul Rudd has more of a supporting role. But they came back, co-starring together this time. And for some reason, no one is talking about it. The Shrink Next Door is a show about the real-life story of Martin Markowitz and Dr. Ike Hershkoff. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Wait, no, what am I talking about? Fuck him. He's the asshole in this. Who cares about his name? If you don't know what I'm talking about, this is a twisted story about a therapist who somehow convinced one of his patients to give him, voluntarily, his mansion, his money, and not only that, but also made him his handyman. Now, I don't know about you, but that is a level of evil I don't think I have ever seen. And this new Apple TV series does a good job at dramatizing it. Now, this show is an 8-episode long series, and only 3 episodes are out so far, so I am limited in my knowledge about what's to come. But I've seen the first few episodes, and I really wanted to make a video about it. So here we are. Will Ferrell and Paul Rudd star in this dark comedy series, acting in a way you've never seen them before, with the weirdest Jewish New Yorker accents.
I do believe you have just had what we head shrinkers call a breakthrough.
Honestly, although the show is classified as a dark comedy, it's a lot more of a drama. Which is weird, because it's not the usual for these stars. But oh boy, do they deliver. I mean, Will Ferrell is giving it his all. He's brilliant as usual and is actually portraying a character that so far doesn't seem very different from what he usually does in movies like The Other Guys and Stranger Than Fiction, but is just a lot more perfected in this one here. Catherine Hahn is also in this show, and she is incredible as usual. I don't know, I'm sorry, I have a soft spot for her, but she honestly does make the show a lot more dramatic and emotional. But the real star here is, in my opinion, Paul Rudd. I have never seen him play a character like this before, but damn, he was good. The first time anyone has ever made me hate Paul Rudd. And how can he hate Paul Rudd? Well, watch this show. Just the sheer subtlety in the way Dr. Ike manipulates Marty into doing his every want while simultaneously making Marty think he's actually helping him is absolutely genius. The ambition and the greed. It's already starting to show on his face, and we're not even halfway through the show. He's also a complete dick to his wife, because, well, spoiler alert, he's gay. He's gay, come on guys, it's obvious. Only time will tell if I'm right. Villain roles that have a lot more finesse and nuance to them like this are a rarity these days. But I was very happy in hating Paul Rudd for once. And I am also gonna be very happy when I see you hit that like button. Much appreciated. Now, I have talked about a lot of the good, mainly the characters, because this show really is kind of a big character study. But there's also a bit of the bad. This show is indeed intriguing, filled with awesome performances, and is just all around fun to watch because of the new way you see these golden stars act. It does have a big pacing issue, though. At many times, and this is only in the first 3 episodes, you notice the slow way events move along and how sometimes they freeze a very mundane and dull storylines. Also, I'm not honestly a big fan of the blue. Blue shots everywhere. The dark way the show is filmed does feel a little much. But honestly, that's about it for the bad. This show has not had the best critical reactions. Not the worst either, but still. I do think it's a lot better than the critics are making it out to be. Although, I have only seen the first 3 episodes, so who am I to judge? Honestly, if you're a fan of any of these actors, it's just gonna be a lot of fun watching them fit into these different kind of roles. The dynamic between Paul Rudd and Will Ferrell is, as usual, absolutely awesome. So, if you've been down lately, trying to have some fun time at home, looking for something intriguing, mysterious, and passionate, then worry not, my friend, because I have the perfect show for you. Watch this video. And Succession. Watch Succession. What was I talking about?